So we have seen so far how to get interference pattern. We need a monochromatic source of light, and then we keep it before a slit, then another cardboard with two very narrow slits. These two acts as coherent sources, and then on a screen we get dark and bright bands of light. Now to find out, we call them fringes. Here we have to find out the fringe width. Now these fringes which are obtained on the screen, they don't have very sharply defined boundaries. Intensity is maximum, it gradually decreases, becomes zero, and then again it increases gradually. So how to find out the width? If I plot this may be the intensity versus say path difference, and if I take this as the center one, center maxima, and then we have a number of maxima, the intensity of all maximas is same, width is also same. But for example, if I take this particular maxima, then the intensity is maximum here, it gradually decreases, it becomes zero. So in order to find out this width of maxima, I will take this distance. This will give me the width of maxima or bright fringe. This will be the width of bright fringe. If I have to find out the width of dark fringe, this will be the width of dark fringe. So in order to find out the fringe width, I need to calculate the center to center distance between two bright fringe or between two dark fringe. For bright fringe, I will calculate center to center distance between two consecutive dark fringes. That will give me the width of bright fringe, and similarly for dark fringe. So let's do this necessary mathematics now. S is again a monochromatic source of light giving us the light of one particular wavelength. S1, S2, two holes on a cardboard. These two act as coherent sources, and we will get fringes on this screen. This is the screen. S1 and S2, they are acting as coherent sources. This is monochromatic source of light. Now, if I take different points, if I take O, the light from S1 and S2, it is covering the same distance, path difference is zero, and for zero, there will be a maxima. Similarly, if I take any other point, if I take a point P, I will have to calculate the path difference. If this path difference is a multiple of lambda, it will be a maxima. If it is a multiple of lambda by 2, it will be a minima. So now, if this distance is d, distance between two coherent sources is small d, distance of a screen from the sources is d, and let us say we have a fringe here which may be either maxima or minima, means a bright fringe or a dark fringe. I have taken the distance from the center of that fringe. Now whether it is maxima or minima, whether I get bright fringe or dark fringe, that will depend on the value of S2P minus S1P. This is the path difference between the two waves reaching at P. I need to calculate this distance using geometry only. If I calculate this value, S2P this distance is d, this is d by 2, and so is this one. So S2P becomes d square plus x plus d by 2, xn plus d by 2 whole square minus S1P, this is this square plus this square. So it is d square plus xn minus d by 2 whole square. This distance is this minus this. This is xn, this is d by 2, xn minus d by 2. This total distance, this plus this. So xn plus d by 2. If I open it, d square will cancel out. Xn square will cancel out. D square by 4. D square by 4, it will be minus, it will be cancelled out. We'll be left with just two terms which will come with by multiplying these two. So let me write the total terms. Xn square plus d square by 4 plus xn d minus d square minus xn square minus minus becomes plus xn d. And this term also, d square by 4. D square plus xn square, d square by 4 minus xn d by 2, there is a minus sign, so it becomes minus xn square minus d square by 4 plus xn by 2. So this term will also cancel. We have 2 xn d. This can also be written as S2P plus S1P into S2P minus S1P is equal to 2 xnb. So S2P minus S1P becomes 2 xnd upon S2P plus S1P. S2P and plus S1P. See, when we are taking the fringes, I will show you a fringe pattern. These fringes are very close to O. So S2P and S1P, they are almost equal, and I will take them as D. S2P almost equal to S1P, and this is D. This is the approximation that we are taking. So it becomes this X and D by D. So this is the path difference between the two waves reaching at P. Now, bright fringe or dark fringe, that will depend upon the value of this path difference. For bright fringe, xn d by d is n lambda, where n is 0, 1, 2, etc. So this will give me n d lambda by d. This gives me distance of nth bright fringe. So distance of n plus 1th bright fringe will be replacing n by n plus 1. And what will be the fringe width? this will be the difference center to center distance between two consecutive brighter fringes. This will give me the fringe width of dark fringe. So it is n plus 1 d lambda by d minus n d lambda by d. It becomes d lambda by d. So this is the fringe width for dark. What will we do for dark fringe? For dark fringe, this should be 2n plus 1 or 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. And then we will get the distance of, this formula is also important, distance of nth bright fringe from the center. Sometimes numerical are asked, calculate the distance of 5th maxima, distance of 6th maxima. So you need to use it directly. Let me do for you even the dark fringe. For dark fringe at P, xn d by d should be 2n minus 1 lambda by 2, where n starts from 1. So xn is 2n minus 1 d lambda by 2d. This gives me distance of nth minima, distance of n plus 1th minima replacing 2 n plus 1, 2n plus 1 d lambda by 2d, and fringe width of bright fringe will be the difference of the two. 2n plus 1 and 2n minus 1. So d lambda by d. Subtract this one from this. 2n plus 1 minus 2n plus 1. So it becomes 2 d lambda by 2d. 2 gets cancelled, d lambda by d. So this is the linear width of the bends. And width means, keep this thing in mind, we don't have very sharply defined strips. We have maximum intensity, then gradually decreasing, it becomes zero, and then gradually increases. So whenever we are calculating the width, we are taking center to center distance between two bright or between two dark. This is the linear width. If I want the angular width, what does angular width means? Angular width means, if this is the linear width, this angle is the angular width. So this is beta and this is d. So beta by d, distance of a screen from the sources, it becomes lambda by d. This will be the angular width of the prism. The fringe width depends on d, the distance between the two coherent sources, d, distance of a screen from the sources, and wavelength of light. If we perform this experiment in some other medium, say in water, lambda will change, and accordingly the fringe width will also change. We can discuss now a few problems in the next class related to the conditions of interference and how this d will affect the observation of the fringes, how the width of each slit will affect the fringes pattern, and so on. Otherwise, mathematically, this is all. So what we have done is, what is interference? When do we get it? We need two coherent sources. Coherent sources means they should give light of same frequency and wavelength, and the phase difference shouldn't change with time. And then we proved it mathematically also, and in a different way, that when we have these two coherent waves for the path difference multiple of lambda, we have maxima multiple of odd multiple of lambda by 2, minima. Even multiple of lambda by 2, maxima. Same way in terms of phase also, 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, maxima, pi, 3 pi, 5 pi, that gives minima. And then we have calculated fringe width for dark as well as bright, and we have seen that the fringe width is same for all fringes, all bright, all dark, they have the same width, d lambda by d. So goodbye, that's all from interference.